So I came out to Vashon today to check up on the progress of two potential seaweed farms that are nearing the end of their permitting process and hope to be the second and third open water seaweed farms in Washington State.
Underneath the water here is effectively a forest that looks just like the forest you'd see above land. There's giant kelp and bull kelp, which are sort of the redwoods of the undersea canopy and forest. But there's 22 different kinds of kelp alone in Puget Sound, and it's one of the more diverse areas of kelp in the world. So we devised what we think is a hybrid model where we will raise bull kelp for restoration purposes and raise other kelp for harvest and cultivation and harvest. And we think that model is a unique model that's both financially self-sustaining but also has huge environmental impact. What we'll do is we will grow bull kelp on lines in the site itself, and we will leave it on the lines. And as its normal biological process, it will release reproductive spores at the end of the summer. And what we're hoping is that those will help to bolster the existing kelp beds north of here, near Blake Island and at the north end of Vashon. So we're just trying to help with a reproduction cycle of bull kelp in the area.
With seaweed farming, you need salt water and sun. Through Colville's Passage, it's very swift water. And a lot of that water is brought up from deep areas, which keeps it cool, and it also makes it very nutrient rich, which the seaweed is gonna love. Sugar kelp, which is the type of seaweed that I'm gonna be growing, grows there natively. You plant seaweed in mid to late November, and you harvest it before the water warms up in around April. So there's one other open water seaweed farm in Washington State, and it's called Blue Dot Sea Farm. Got a product line that's based in kelp, and it's quite delicious. So not only are they the growers, but they're a producer of a great seaweed snack. I plan on being the second open water seaweed farm. So with that comes a lot of excitement. There's also a lot of challenges, but also getting a lot of help from organizations like Seagram.
Unlike terrestrial farmers that can rent or own a piece of land and farm it as they wish, people who farm in the marine environment are doing so in a place that's really considered the commons. Sea farmers are beholden to the people who live near, work on, and care about our common marine waters. And they have a responsibility to be transparent and responsive to all the constituents. The path to getting a permit to farm seaweed in Washington State is a long one. It takes time and patience, and there are many steps, but those steps are there for a reason.
Getting a permit should be subject to review by the tribes and agencies who are stewarding our waters and by the public who also enjoy and use these waters.
Everybody should be able to learn what's going on and have their say and feel satisfied when permits are granted that the right thing is happening. So if you're looking to become a seaweed farmer in Washington, the good news is you don't have to go it alone. There are so many opportunities to learn from others who are headed down the same path and share your goals. And that's where Washington Sea Grant can really help. We're great at convening people, and we're doing that right now with the seaweed community in Washington State.